Hello folks, welcome back to another video. Before we dive into this tour of this application and an overview, I wanted to thank Notion for being the sponsor of January 2020. They are the sponsors this month and you can find out all the details about them below. Now, Notion is an all-in-one workspace. I use it for a range of things and most importantly, holistically managing my work. I use it as my project manager. I use it as a way to be able to see for example, like each week I have like a business development Thursdays sort of thing where I sit down, I sort of overview what's working, what's not working in terms of activities that I'm doing. So it's almost like a holistical planner for me. I also use it to manage our upcoming list of stuff we need to get for the baby, also workouts, habits, and for finance too. So it's also become a treasure trove for planning and coordinating the majority of my life. Now you can check it out in the link in description. I want to pay particular focus on the New Year's templates that are available. I'll include that link in the description, but you can use the 2019 year in review, the 2020 simple resolutions, and also a great one that allows you to plan a bucket list too. So Notion is really accessible. I recommend checking it out in the link in description. Thank you guys. Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. On today's feature, we're going to be taking a look at Nozbe Teams. Now, Nozbe has been an application that's been around for a while. I believe they've been developing for about 12 years now, which has been a very long time. And this application is now a Teams application. So Nozbe Teams is available separately to Nozbe, which is more of a personal application now, and it is currently in open beta. So as of this video, you'll have to check the link in the description because obviously it may have changed since then, but they are rolling this out to a set amount of users. Now, as you can imagine, Nozbe has been working on applications for a fair while. I believe they've been developing since 2007, which is a good 12 years as of last year. And they've been sort of like, you know, getting the idea. I remember I'm having a coffee with Michael Slewinski, who's the founder of Nozbe. Hopefully I got his last name correctly pronunciated. But he did mention Teams and their plans to release it. And I want to show you this trailer that they created before we dive in, because obviously it showcases what it looks like on iOS and obviously web and Mac as well. So let's roll into that video. So coming out of that, what I want to do with you guys is show you some of the features and abilities. So as you can see, this is the web dashboard. I've just full paged it. So you can see up here, you've got this traditional side panel. So let's start out with that. You've got priority at the top, which is a star. So anything obviously that is a task, that is a priority. If you star it in the top right hand corner, you'll be able to get that prioritized, which is quite good. And what I quite like about this area here is you've got sort of like what is priority, which you can dismiss, but if you're a brand new user, you can click in and actually understand the reasons to why you are setting this as a priority. So these are the most important bits of work that you can focus on, and that's why it's at the top. I quite like that positioning of that task, especially for Teams. So down just below, you've got incoming, and incoming is a section that is more about where your attention is due. It's more of like your inbox per se. So you can see tasks that are overdue. So that would appear just above this reminders. Ones with any reminders on, ones that have been assigned to you, and ones that you were mentioned in. So as you can see here, if I click in, you can go over to here and set a reminder on any task, and that's why that is here. So if I were to set a reminder, I can tick that off. And as you can see, the task is completed. We'll come onto this sort of task dashboard here that can be useful for you and your team, but let's just go off this now. You can also see that this task was assigned to me. So that's how you assign to someone. So I could assign this to Alice or unsign it in case I didn't want to have it for anyone there. So that's obviously a task that's been assigned to me. And you can also see the ones that you've been mentioned in. So as you can see here, there's a comment below which includes me in it. So that's why I was featured in this one. So what's quite cool is once you've finished your incoming, you've reviewed everything there. So they recommend you go to priority. So you can flick up there. But as you can imagine, anything that is, you know, needing your attention goes here. And for teams, that's quite important because you want to be able to see what you and your team are struggling on or that needs attention. Now, if you want a sort of outline of everything that's been going on per task, what you can have is this activity area. So you can see 16 tasks are done, and that's everything from comments to new tasks to new projects. And you can clear this up here. So as you can see, it breaks it down for the project, and you can even open that one up there. But if I went to read that, you can see you're sort of caught up with everything there. So that's a handy way to see activity that you and your team are working on. It's a little bit different to incoming because incoming is more about things that you need to review, and hopefully we can come back to that a little bit later. So you can see here that there's, I quite like this concept, this concept of single tasks. So for example, like let's say you didn't you had a project that, you know, you had a project down here, everything's, you know, very clear, I guess, like, you know, upgrade content calendar, redo website, you know, everything that goes into there is very much a task for those projects. And you're going to be staying in those projects, but this is single tasks and this is designed so that you can see all of the tasks that don't necessarily have a set project. So that's quite cool. So for example, if I went ahead and created a new task, you can see that it pops up at the top. And let's say something very simple like get new office water machine could be a task, and I pressed enter. You can see obviously there, when you open this one up, there are a few things you can do here. For example, you can actually move it to the bottom or top, which is quite nice. So for example, if you just wanted to do that, and I believe there are some keyboard shortcuts here, so there will be some available. You can assign it to a person. So for example, if that single task is you know, something for Alice, then you can do that there, but they have to be invited, remember, to the single tasks area. And also you've got the due date as well as setting a time. So for example, if I went to that get office water, you can see that the water machine, you can see that the task view opens up now. Now from here, you can actually change the project. So if I wanted to add that to the onboarding, you can see here that it's locked. That means it is actually a static experience on that left hand panel, which is good if you're someone that you know, wants single tasks to be consistent there. You can actually add it to a section if you went ahead and created a section to your project, and maybe we'll demonstrate that in the projects area. But you can also add the responsibility here and any tags as well. So for example, they could be, you know, office errands, but you have to go ahead and set up those tags before, and that can be set up down here. Let's do that now just very quickly. So let's say admin, because that could be an admin one. You can set a color or also an icon as well. So maybe the wrench, I'm not sure. And I could go here and add that as an admin task there. Now you can see here that the color changes when you're on it, but I actually thought it changed it when you were on there. And you get task activities updated up here or down here. And you can add a due date as well. So for example, if I was like, okay, by Friday, I want the office water machine updated, and remind me tomorrow at 9 a.m, although you can pick a day and one before the due date. So that's quite cool. You can actually have how many days before the due date that you pick, that you get reminded on. So down here, you can open up these changes. That's quite nice because you don't necessarily get like a hideously long, winded sort of change log. So it will just say three changes. And just below here, you can start adding tasks. So, for example, you could add some markdown tasks or checklist or bullet checklist and even open it up here so that you can get a full view. And what's cool is you can paste it or post it as a comment, which is very handy. Now, before we move away from the task view, up here you can mark as unread. So if I pressed mark as unread, I will show you what happens to that in a moment. And I can also rename the task here. So if I go to mark as unread, you can see that get office water comes up in activities and something that I need to read. However, let's say that I set this due date to the past. And you can see here, you are setting the due date to the past, and this means that it's been marked as overdue. So let's say this is an overdue task now. What I can do is go to incoming. I should go to incoming and be able to see it there. Let's see, because it should have moved over automatically. Let's give it a few moments in case there's, you know, some beta slowness of it, but as you can imagine, it should appear here. But let's go and look at projects. So you can follow projects, but the way to go ahead and create a project is by going here. So I could say, a new website as a new project, something that many marketing teams may have. You can also choose who sees the project, invited members, so you can add specific people. So I could be like, okay, I want only me and Alice to see it there. And you can also set a project purpose as well as a color. So for example, renew the website design by 32. If I go ahead and press create, you can see the project purpose comes up here, which is quite nice because it sets you and your team to be aligned there. And you can also turn it off if you want to. But as you can see, a new project, you can add tasks in a very similar fashion to how you did a moment ago. So for example, if I said something like, redo banner or hire designer to design banner, the task gets added to the project, and I can go up here and I can star it, and as you can see, just do everything I did in the previous thing. So that's very useful. And the great thing is, if I had a single task, I could drag it into a project, which is something that I know a lot of people like to do. So obviously that's how projects work. You can access your tags down here and it will break it down per project, which is very helpful. Also, you can go onto your own tasks. It says up here that I've got 21 tasks selected. I can go onto my own profile. I can set a description, set an alias, which is quite cool, and show all of my completed tasks. And obviously that won't appear if, for example, oh yeah, it does show all completed if you and your team. And you can also promote team members to admin as well, and also remove them from the team as well as favorite them there. So if I went ahead and favorited Alice, maybe I want to see her regular features come up. You can also go to, I believe, go here to the projects. So inside the project, you can create a section. You can end a project as well. So that's quite handy, so you don't get that clutter. But you also can go and see completed projects as well. But you can also favorite it. So if I wanted to favorite a project or a person, I could do pretty smoothly. Now there are some smart lists down here. I didn't actually know how to go and create a smart list, but you can see here smart list is next 30 days, anything that's overdue and any tasks that are coming up. So you can see here that that allows you to see any tasks that you have inside of your area. So guys, as you can imagine, this is a really simple but nice experience at the moment. I think a lot of people that are small businesses, freelancers that have many different individuals that work with them, and that like a traditional project management application, will like this application. It has a few features that I think stand out. I think the single task is a nice experience. I think the ability to create sections and projects is nice. I think the design will get on with, especially on your mobile devices. Tags are very helpful, and also the smart lists as they grow will become your more useful, as well as the incoming area, especially if you want to review everything in tandem. But this is a great traditional task manager, and also a great project manager. It doesn't have some of the hideously advanced abilities like automations and things like that, but this is targeting more towards small businesses, so this might be suitable for you. So guys, you can check out the link in the description, and I'll also mention any other links that you might find helpful to it. But I just want to say a big thank you. But guys, a big thank you for stopping by today. If you enjoyed this feature, hit the like button. It's just below this video. And you can also subscribe if you are brand new to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. We put out regular features and looking to do more in the project management spectrum, so you guys can check that out. But a big thank you. Feel free to comment if you've had an experience with Nozbe. But guys, thank you very much. I'll talk to you guys very soon. Cheers, everyone. Bye.